Good evening, sports fans, and welcome to the very first episode of The Game Plan. Now, I know, like, what's Gofred Akoto doing here? Well, I've decided that every evening from Monday to Thursday, I'll be coming your way right here on pulse.com.gh to give you the latest in sports. And that's why I'm here. And this is not like going to be like my everyday kind of, you know, conversation that I have. This is a very social conversation because we're on social media. Now, that means that you need to be part of the show. Contribute, just comment, ask any questions. I'll find time and respond to all that. But on our very first episode, what am I going to be talking about? Well, I'll be talking about Kwesi Appiah, of course. Black Stars issues, that's definitely on the line. I'll be talking about Kumasi Asante-Kotoko. Yeah, Kotoko fans, I'm talking about you guys. Kumasi Asante-Kotoko. And the fire coach, Drafko Lugaric, and who comes in. Okay, so let me get the show started. Those of you who have comments, like I said, just keep them rolling down there. Those of you who are watching via Twitter, hashtag, yes, hashtag, game plan. Let's get it trending, trend. And I'll gladly read your comments as and when they come to me. I'll also be giving away some free credit later on. Yeah, free credit. Some guys already won, but I have names in front of me. So I'll be giving out some free credit as well. That's what you get if you watch this show on pulse.com.gh. Okay, so let's start with the Kumasi Asante-Kotoko conversation. And Kotoko fans, I know you're going to be upset with me, but are you out of your minds? Like, honestly. You sacked your coach? Really? Now, I know management said they took the decision, but I'm blaming you, Kotoko fans. Kotoko fans, you took this decision because you've been shouting at this coach ever since you lost to Accra to Folk. And that's where I think the problem starts from. Kumasi Asante-Kotoko did not get over the loss to Accra to Folk. It's been since, what, match day 8? It's been 3 matches, and Kumasi Asante-Kotoko are still suffering from the hangover of losing to Accra to Folk. Yeah. Otherwise, why would you be whining? Everybody, you guys went, what, 2 weeks complaining about referee Samuel Suka, forgetting that you had to focus on the league season ahead of you. And I think that you did not help Drafko Lugaric in that context, because after losing that game, you wanted positive results. And that meant that anything that he did was going to come under some kind of scrutiny. Unfortunately for him, it's been his 3-5-2 that has come under scrutiny from Kumasi Asante-Kotoko fans. And I think it's very, very, very unfair to the man. Look, you guys are saying the tactics is not working. What is your infatuation with this 4-4-2? 4-4-2, a trim. Let me be honest with you people. I keep hearing sports fans, even some pundits, come and say, look, 4-4-2 is the Ghana style. Who made the style for Ghana? Did you guys make the style for Ghana? Who was born in Ghana saying that we want to play 4-4-2? Is there any footballer born in this country, Ayatro, 4-4-2? I can only play 4-4-2. Look, you are not forcing our footballers to learn. We have footballers who leave this country, and as soon as they leave, suddenly are able to adapt to all kinds of formations. Very few teams are playing 4-4-2. So I don't really understand this infatuation with this coach did not allow us to play our traditional 4-4-2, and that he had all kinds of big names at his expense. Big what? Awal Mohamed, kicked out of Raja Casablanca, could not get a game for 2 years out there, comes back to Kumasi Asante-Kotoko, and you think he's a big name player? Forgive me, I'm not buying it. Michael Akufu, 2 years sitting on the bench. He comes, he's starting against Kumasi Asante-Kotoko. You want to win? Really? Emmanuel Jenfi, Pajero, yeah! He's the newborn star. Where was Emmanuel Jenfi last year? Nobody knew him. Who brought him to the limelight? The same coach you just fired. Drafko Lugaric. Give the man some credit, people. I've seen, you know, a good friend of mine put a sketch out there on Facebook. Yeah, and he says that's Kwesi Kranting. Yeah, Kwesi Kranting, I'm mentioning your name. He says, this is apostasy. And he lines out the Kumasi Asante-Kotoko formation in what looks like what a formation that has 7 or 8 defenders in there. It's how they play on the pitch, my friends. It's not the names, it's how they play. We need to tell our players to adapt to new positions. Michael Essien was a centre-back when he was at Liberty Professionals. I saw him. Did Michael Essien make his name as a centre-back? Yo! Defensive midfielder. Emmanuel Osekufor, defender most of his life. Became known as what? A striker. A very good one. Later days in his career, he became known as what? A very, very good central midfielder as well. So players need to go through these motions. And you, the fans of Kumasi Asante-Kotoko, should have allowed this to happen. Now, check out these disgraceful scenes. You just check this out. I mean, look at the security. Come on. And this is not the worst for me. The worst was that you people allowed Seydou. And I'm going to mention his name. Seydou, I don't care if he meets me in Kumasi and gets issues with me. But Kotoko fans, you guys need to kick out this guy from your football club. Last year, he was busy beating a journalist. Another time, he's going around assaulting everybody in the name of Kumasi Asante Kotoko. He's doing it in your name. And you go ahead and fire your coach after this Seydou guy, this Seydou character. What does he contribute to Kotoko apart from being a thug? What does he contribute? So if you guys decide that, oh, this is what we're going to do based on all these things, I am certainly not in agreement. I feel that, yes, there is need for improvement, but I also feel that it has come to the time where you need to be patient. Kumasi Asante Kotoko fans need to understand the reality of their present-day status. What is the present-day status of Kumasi Asante Kotoko? A husband. Yeah, Kotoko, you are a husband. Same as Accra Asofok, a husband. The modern clubs of today in Ghana are the ones who are winning the league. It's more open. Accept the fact that any team in Ghana can win the league. If you put your house in order, of course you will dominate like others are dominating in other countries. The Al Hilals, the Al Mereks, the Alis, the Zamaleks are dominating in their countries. But until you put your house in order, you are fair game for the Midiamas. You are fair game for Liberty. You are fair game for Ebusua Dwarfs. You are fair game for Inter Allies. So don't scream when these teams come and get points out of you. Okay, now you fired a coach who, by the time he was fired, had 19 points. Right? 19 points. That in 11 games. How many games are you going to give the next person who comes in? How many games are you going to give that one? I'm just asking. And let me just read this, you know. Let me just go through this. Now, the last four coaches that Kumasi Asante Kotoko have had, Masudi Dramani, David Duncan, Michael Osei, and Drafko. Let's just go through the numbers. Okay? Allow me to read this. Okay, so David Duncan in his 11 games, because most of them joined Kotoko at different times of the season. So I'm not going to look at how they started the league, but their first 11 games. Now, David Duncan won 5 games, drew 3, and lost 3, 18 points in his first 11. Masudi Dramani won 4, drew 5, lost 2 for 17 points. Michael Osei won 8, drew 1, lost 2 in his first 11 games. He won 25 points. Drafko Garozic won 4, drew 5, lost 1. 19 points. Fired. So, I'm just praying for whoever has come to take the job. And now here's Marcelo Bielsa. No? Jose Mourinho. Pep Guardiola. Bashir Hayford. Let me reduce my standards. Bashir Hayford, back to Kotoko. Who is coming? Michael Osei just went to Ashgold from what I'm told. So, I've heard Frimpong Manso. Frimpong Manso couldn't coach Karela. But you think he's good enough to coach Kumasi Asante Kotoko? Kumasi Asante Kotoko fans, you need to be realistic with the times. Okay? So, I know you're going to be upset with me for saying this, but things need to change. And it needs to change from you, the fans. Have a bit of patience. Allow a team to go through the whole process of the season. Now, let's take Wafa and Adriana that you seem to think are so far ahead of you. With good reason. Wafa lost one player last season. He's at Inter Allies. They are captain Martin Entry. They let him go because they felt they could let him go. Either than that, it's the same Wafa team of the past 3 years. Top of the league, unbeaten in 5. It's the result of projected work. Adriana has been the same team for the past 4 or 5 years. Guess who they let go? Seth Opare. Who does he play for? Kumasi Asante Kotoko. And he can't even get a game at Kotoko. And you expect to win against teams like this? No. So you see, you need to consider this. Be patient with the rebuilding project and everything will be fine with you guys. Okay? So don't be upset. Cool? Kotoko fans, you're cool, right? You're cool because I'm putting my face down here. So, guys, let's be cool. All right, anyway, I hope you're still enjoying the show. It's The Game Plan, live on pause.com.gh. We'll be doing this every evening, Monday to Thursday from 9 p.m. 9K. Okay, now I owe some of you credit. Like before I started, we asked some of you to predict when the time will start. And so a few of you got that right and won credit. And after that, after I announce the winners, I'm going to go to the chat regarding Kwesi Appiah and his return to the Black Star. So let's see. Chris Zose. I hope I pronounced the name right. Chris Zose or Wese. I think it's Wese. Like X is pronounced W. So I think it's Chris Wese. You've won yourself some credit. Alfred Fifi Keita. You also won yourself some credit. Kwabena Mensah Suarez Jr. That's an interesting name. Kwabena Mensah Suarez Jr. Felix Komi Williams and Ano Gerard Emmanuel. All you guys have won credit from this show. So just pass through our offices at East Legon, America House. and the credit is yours. Just tell us which network you use and we'll get you the 10 Ghana CDs worth of credit for each and every single one of you. Chris Wesse, Alfred Fifi Keita, Kwabena Mensah Suarez Jr., Felix Kommy Williams, and no Gerard Emmanuel. Now, don't forget that on Twitter, you're also supposed to be tweeting using the hashtag GamePlan, and I have some prizes for you out there on Twitter. Those of you who tweeted us and send in the best comments and the best questions, I'll surprise you guys later. Okay, second one, Kwesi Appiah. Now, it's old news, his return and everything, but to give us better perspective on what he's bringing to the Black Stars, we went all the way to Sudan and spoke to Abdul Musa Jr., who's a correspondent with a freelance correspondent, I must say, of Sudanese football. And this is what he had to say.
Hello, Abdul.
Hello, how my friend?
How are you?
I'm good, my friend. Thank you.
Thank you so much for finding time for me this morning.
No problem, my friend, anytime.
Okay, so first question I will ask is, how well regarded was Kwesi Appiah in Sudanese football?
I think it can be. Yeah, he was given his farewell, how well he was respected at the club, and how were proud of what he did at the club. I think the main problem with Kwesi Appiah is that he wasn't able to grind the necessary results to compete with the top two in Sudan, Al Hilal and Mariha. And this is what we all expected, coming from the background of just leading the Ghanaian national team at the 2014 World Cup. I think we were expecting more in terms of results, but he has done development in terms of finding stability. I think Khartoum played well. His style of play has developed as well, but I think it's just mainly that he wasn't able to compete with the top two. I think this was his main downfall. Khartoum.
But there are those who would say Hilal, Merek are so far ahead of the rest, it would be quite unreasonable to expect any coach to compete.
Exactly. I think that Khartoum had high hopes of Kwesi Appiah. I think because nobody has been able to compete with Hilal Merih in recent times, I think that he was coming from the background of leading Ghana in the World Cup, also bringing in Ghanaian players. I think he was the most. They thought that he was able to do so, but as you said, they are far ahead of everyone else, and unfortunately, he wasn't able. I think it would have been one of the biggest breakthroughs if he was able to compete with them. But other than that, I think he has done well, and he has been well respected at the club. And I think all the players, I have spoken with some of the players at Khartoum Awatini, they're very deeply saddened by his departure, and they consider him a father before coach, really.
Now, observing him, I'm sure you watched how he was with Ghana in 2014, would you say yes, Ghana should expect anything new after his Sudan experience, or he's still the same calm, level-headed gentleman we knew from 3 years ago?
No, I think he has gained good experience with Khartoum Awatini, especially guiding them in CAF competitions. So he has been through a lot with the club. He has faced a new challenge, trying to compete with the top two in Sudan, and also, as I said, trying to guide them in CAF competition. So I think he's a more aggressive coach now. I think he can build a better partnership with the Ghanaian players. He's not that kind of person where he doesn't speak or doesn't have a say anymore. I think he's a much more aggressive coach now.
Okay then. Thank you very much, Ahmed.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. That was Abdul, and I hope he's provided some perspective. Apparently, from what he's saying, Kwesi Appiah, very highly rated in Sudan. A lot of the players looked up to him as a father figure. Abdul also feels that he has improved, which was a problem because a lot of people still judge Kwesi Appiah by the 2014 standards, forgetting that we are in the year 2017. And I, for one, am willing to give him as much room as possible. I don't know what most of you think. It's been really polarizing out there. Some have said that he's not competent enough, he's not learned lessons, we should have brought a white man, and I don't know. But the announcement has been made, and I have decided to move on from there. But what does he need to do to succeed? What really does he need to do? For me, like I said earlier on, I wrote an article on the website, and I said this: sack some players. Some players deserve to get sacked. Like, somebody's going to ask me who? Edwin Jima, sack him! Like, really? Yeah, get rid of Edwin Jima. What was he doing in the national team? I really don't get it. I saw Bernard Tekwete. I liked what I saw. Do I feel he's ready? I don't really think so. I don't. Harrison Afu needs a break as well. Yeah. I'm just being honest with you. Harrison Afu needs a break as well. Razak Brahma needs a break. I think he's not good enough for our national team. Yeah, we've carried him along for long enough. Let's get some true quality. Let's get some competition going in the team. You know, let's bring in some young blood who are ready to fight. You know, and let's get going. So for me, Kwesi Appiah needs to bring in some new players so that we get some competition. Again, you're going to ask, which new players? You know who are those playing? Chaliso, let those ones come and let's get it going. Second one for me, captaincy. Taboo topic. Taboo. Yeah, taboo. But whether we like it or not, it's an issue. Now, it's funny it's an issue because the whole world knows who is the Black Stars captain, except the players of the Ghana Black Stars. Everybody knows who is Black Stars captain. Asamoah Gyan, true or false? But even on social media, there is Andre Ayew for Black Stars captain fan page. I know a lot of you are going to comment, are going to say Andre Ayew should be captain. But the thing is this, until Asamoah Gyan decides he no longer wants to be captain, he is going to be captain. But the true problem is this. This argument that we normally have on radio, on TV, on social media, has affected the team. There are factions. Management will not admit it to you, but there are factions. There's the Asamoah Gyan faction. There is the Andre Ayew faction. Which is, again, unfortunate considering we know who the captain is. So what Kwesi Appiah, in my book, needs to do, as soon as he set foot in the country, and he's in the country, he arrived on Saturday, is... A, speak up and say, this is my captain. I want all of you to support this particular person. And let's move on from there. Because what most of us don't get is this. If there is that continued factions in our team, it affects focus when we are playing in tournaments. It affects focus when we are playing matches. All this drama, pregame, who's going to be captain today, who's going to be captain tomorrow. It's not good for team building. It's not good for the focus of the team. It's not good for the mentality of the players. So Kwesi Appiah needs to kill it quick. Quick. Either he reinforces Asamoah Gyan as captain. If he feels that, okay, this is a new tenure for me, so I need to name a new captain, fine, it's his prerogative. Name a new captain, but do it fast and do it forcefully. Okay? Forcefully. So that we can move on from there. Otherwise, some way for me. This captaincy issue, you know, it's just wasting too much time. Now, there are a host of other things I wish I could talk about, but I won't. These are the two I want to focus on. Again, regarding Kwesi Appiah, questions have come up about his backroom staff. Tanko will be assistant. They are not saying it, but I'm telling you, Tanko will be assistant. I told you a month ago or 2 months ago, Kwesi Appiah will be coach. Tanko will be assistant. The problem is Maxwell Kunedu. I know he knows, everybody knows that Maxwell, they don't want him. Kwesi Appiah does not want Maxwell back as assistant. Yeah, there are those who feel that there's a media campaign to get Maxwell out. I don't know about the media campaign. I only know what I think. 5 years, you couldn't be head coach. Walk. Yeah, walk. The Kotoko job is available, right? You should apply for it. I think Maxwell can get the Kotoko job just like that. But he needs to move on. This whole business of two assistants at the national team level, it won't work. Trust me, it won't work. If you've given Kwesi Appiah the job, let him pick who he wants. I know for certain he's picked Tanko. He hasn't picked Maxwell. But they say Maxwell is there. They need to sort out that issue. Second one, and I'm going to be very plain about it. Those of you who think that sacking Sabankwe is a good idea, forget it. Sacking Sabankwe is not a good idea for the team manager. He's not the most popular figure, I know. All right? Because of his hassle folk and a lot of you say, oh, Sabankwe, all he's good for is juju. Really? You think so? Being team manager, we don't see as much as we need to see. We just think that, oh, he's just walking around, you know, with his, you know, Sabankwe. Yeah. That's all we see. No. So I've heard sentimental moves. Oh, let's give it to Tornado. Whatever. I love Tornado. Steven Appiah. I think he'll make a fantastic addition to the technical team in some capacity. Not as team manager. No. It's an administrative job. It's a job that requires a certain kind of qualification. It's not a job you hang out, you know, you hand out based on emotions. Listen to me carefully. I love social media. You know, you can always check these things. And like, if I'm wrong, just list this out. check all the national teams and check who is team manager. Like those who you feel are at Ghana's level. Don't go beyond, you know, Ghana is a good national team. It's a reasonably good national team. And check who is the team manager. In addition to being an ex-international, yeah, you see the first one they have in common. And that's where Tornado comes in. They are all ex-internationals. Then check the second one. All of them are overly qualified for the job. Most of them could be CEOs of banks. Oliver Bierhoff, Demetrio Albertini, Alphonse Tchami, Cameroon. Check Nigeria. Check Egypt. Check Algeria. You just check. You check and write, put the names in the comment section. You just check. I'll wait. I'm waiting. Really. You see? So it's not just about being a beloved ex-international. It's about being a qualified ex-international. Then we can have this conversation. So they might have other names. I feel, you know, there are a lot of qualified Ghanaian ex-internationals out there who can also do this job if they really want Sabankwe out. But institutional memory is important, and that's what Sabankwe has. So for me, I'm vouching for Sabankwe. Keep Sabankwe or bring another qualified ex-international in his place. And I don't mean an emotional qualification. No, I'm talking about a proper qualification in this regard. Then we are fine on this particular backroom staff issue. You know, so yeah, that's all for the Black Stars. All for the Black Stars. We are going really, really fast on the first episode today. Like I said, I'll be back tomorrow. And we'll be sharing highlights everywhere, you know, Pulse TV and all those places. So I hope you're having fun as I am. My name is Godfrey Akutubo. And for those of you who want to hit me up on Twitter, at East Sportsman, that's my Twitter handle. Or you can just, you know, just give us the hashtag game plan on at Pulse Ghana Sports. That's our Twitter handle. And also right here on Facebook, you can send in your comments. Okay, so I'm entering the third phase of the show, you know, and then we'll run out of here because it's late. You guys need to go to bed, like myself. Ghanaian players out there, like those who did well this week. A few did caught my eye. Charlie, Kevin Prince-Boateng is giving me headaches. I know he's giving you headaches too. 9 goals this season. Well, he's no longer a midfielder. He's a striker, out and out striker. So a striker who has scored 9 goals, I think that is good, you know. And I get a lot of messages from you guys out there who are like, Godfred, Kevin Prince-Boateng should come back to the Black Stars. Kevin, Charlie, I know we want the best players to play for our national team, don't we? We want the best players. And at the moment, he's the best Ghanaian player out there, along with Kojo Asamoah. Okay? But the garbage he brings, Charlie, I'm not saying baggage, the garbage that Kevin Prince-Boateng brings. You know, I've heard all the and read all the stories about, oh, I've changed. I've become more mature. Yeah. But I know two things for a fact. His knees are still bad. You know, and Kevin's knees, let's be honest, Kevin's knees will not play qualifiers at Accra Sports Stadium and Mabayara. Let's be honest about it. And he knows this. If we want Kevin back, let's accept that he only play matches in Europe. Because the nature of his injuries, he's fine. He's recovered and all. But that's because he's also playing in an environment that is conducive for him. The pitches are fantastic. Our pitches are hard. Charlie, if you played at Accra Sports Stadium before, maybe now you're a ball. You know, like a ball. He's not, and Kevin is not in that kind of form. But I don't know what you guys think. Do you think like we should bring him back? You know, he's been suspended from the national team and all, right? So I'm just thinking, like, 9 goals. Do we bring Kevin back? Well, I say no. I leave it to you guys, but I say no. I think once we've decided to move on, let's move on. Okay, because like I heard those who said, let's bring back Sule Muntari, even when Sule Muntari had been staying home for 1 year. And I was like, what is he going to do in the national team after staying home for 1 year? If we've moved on from ACN Sule Muntari, let's enjoy Kevin now at Las Palmas. But let us end it there. Let us just enjoy him. You know, because Charlie, hey, this boy, people like him more. I'm just looking at the comments, like, people just like this Kevin Prince-Boateng boy, you know? Abdul Majid Waris, he scored 8 this season as well. Missed the AFCON. And after the AFCON, like, he had scored just 2 goals before the AFCON. After the AFCON, he scored 6, you know? And he scored a stunner against Olympic Lyon. Just check this out. Check it out. Yeah. He did this against Lyon. Like, this is like Zidane-ish levels. It's a crazy goal. that Warriors scored. I didn't even think Warriors had this in him. Like, to, he didn't even look at this. You just look at the goal again. As for me, I'm in awe. Like, I'm really in awe. I didn't think Warriors had this in him. But I think it's also a sign of his maturity that he's able to take chances like this, to bend the ball like that. Warriors used to be a penalty box guy. But look at this. I mean, it's incredible. So he had a good week as well. We are keeping that with him. Kojo Asamoah, I'm happy for Kojo Asamoah. I'm very happy. And I think he's the one player we have really missed in the Black Stars. Everybody who knows me knows I have a personal bias for Kojo Asamoah. So I'm not even talk too much. But he had a good week playing for Juventus as well. And him, I think that Kwesi Appiah should make that trip and have a conversation with Kojo Asamoah about coming back. We've missed Kojo Asamoah's quality. Look, we can say, oh, we reached finals and whatnot. But Kojo Asamoah's added quality perhaps would have taken us further than we are now. So I'm looking forward to welcoming Kojo Asamoah back, you know. And it wasn't all roses for Ghanaian players. I found out that they're bitter rough. Eyimba went to play a game in Kano or somewhere. And from the videos we saw, I mean, horrible. It's not like the hooliganism is everywhere on the African continent. Their bus was stoned. You know, players, you know, got injured from pieces of glass that broke. It's just, it's not palatable. That's not what we want to see, you know, about African football. It happens all over the world. But hey, our concern is African football. So this one, you know, really, really affects us. But hey, well done to Fatah Odau that he seems to be doing the business. Now, I promise you, I want you to enjoy this guy because tomorrow we are interviewing him live on the show. Rafael Jamna. Yeah. My director is a personal fan of his. He's laughing. My director is a personal fan of Rafael Jamna. And we are interviewing Rafael live on the game plan tomorrow. Now, I don't know how Rafael Jamna did not go to AFCON. I'm like, if I could insult him on this show, I would insult him. But beyond that, but how Rafael Jamna did not make the AFCON beats my mind. You just watch this. Those of you who haven't seen Rafael Jamna, just watch this. Okay, so now let me give you some nice stats. Rafael Jamna has scored 31 goals in 37 matches this year, like this football season. 31 goals, 37 matches. When we were going to the AFCON, he had scored 24 goals in 27. Since he went to Switzerland, he has played 8 matches. He has scored 6. How in God's name did this guy not go to the AFCON? But let's get beyond that. You know, it's the future. And tomorrow he'll be telling us what he has planned, you know, how he got over the AFCON business. And when we are seeing him for the Black Stars, I'm looking forward to seeing him. Yeah, like you can call this an advert or something, but I think I'll be out of my mind if I don't advocate for a striker who has scored 30-plus goals in any season. Abraham Grant didn't see it good. I see it good. So I'm saying Rafael Jamna. Yeah, I'm going to show the highlights. I'm going to interview him tomorrow. So make a date tomorrow. And final one before I go. Yaya Boah, you know, Manchester City, Pep Guardiola wants to keep me, then was sent on loan. You remember that, Yaya Boah? Yeah. He's having a good season in Holland, playing for FC 20. He's like played 19 games, scored 2 goals, been very good. He's one of the better Ghanaian players out there. Reports are that he could be heading for FC Porto, former home of Cristiano Ronaldo. That would be interesting. Not on a permanent deal, another loan. I'm wondering why he's leaving Holland, where he's playing well, to go to a very competitive FC Porto team. But perhaps it would also be that his style of play fits Portuguese football. He's a very skillful player, you know, sweet player. Another player I felt should have been at the AFCON, but they didn't make it. Thank you very much, Avram Grant, for doing all these criminal things to us. We hope you enjoy your severance pay from Ghana. Yeah, your boy didn't go to the AFCON. Avram Grant, hey, one of these. I have to dedicate one of these episodes to just ranting about Avram Grant. I think so, you know. So, quick one. Yeah, my time is up. I need to go. Hope you guys enjoyed the first episode of The Game Plan. Tomorrow we'll be back, same time, 9 p.m. live. My name is Godfred Akotoboafo. And don't forget, the hashtag is GamePlan on Twitter. Okay? And it's the same for Facebook as well. Follow all our channels, pulse.com.gh, Pulse Ghana Sports, Pulse Ghana. Like I'm being, Pulse Ghana Sports, Pulse Ghana. On Facebook, on Instagram, Twitter, Snapchat, just we are everywhere. Okay? I hope you enjoyed it. Those of you whose questions are in there, I'll be responding to them personally, so don't worry. All right? Tomorrow, 9 p.m. Have a good night.